Hello, Kevin Bacon again. Let's talk about today's project. Now, today's project, last week we set the greenhouse in the window, and it needs to be covered so that we can put a heater in it, because in my particular situation here, my house is not heated to 65 degrees, which is a really good ground temperature for our seeds. And we like to have our seedlings about that temperature. That's when they seem to be the happiest. Anyway, so we're going to cover that. We're going to cover one side of it with clear plastic so that the sun can shine in. I may get more than one side covered with the clear plastic. And then we'll put a heater in there to keep that temperature. Now, that's a very small area, so it's not going to take much of a heater to do that job. Perhaps a 60-watt light bulb or something on that order. Can't buy those anymore, but you can buy 53-watt halogen bulbs. So a 53-watt halogen bulb gets pretty hot. And you put that in there and you test your temperatures, or you put it in with a thermostat. In my case, I'm going to put it in with a thermostat eventually. But my actual seed propagation chamber for my first batch of seeds is going to be a cooler. Just like a Coleman cooler or one of these picnic coolers that you'd buy. It's a fairly large one. And I have a fish tank heater. It's only 25 watts, but in fact, I've used it to make yogurt in the past, if you watch my yogurt videos. And I'm going to put a gallon jug of water inside of this cooler, and I'm going to put that inside the heater in the jug of water, and it'll provide two things. It'll keep some humidity in there, which is something that we want, and it will also bring the temperature up to at least 65 degrees. Now, I don't care if the temperature goes up to 80 or 75. It won't bother me a bit. The seeds won't care. As long as we don't get too hot, they'll be happy. Okay, now let's talk about preparing our seed. I know that for most of you people out there, you say, preparing the seed? I mean, all we do is just stick it in the soil. But I'm not going to do that. I notice that a lot of times when I buy seed that the germination rate on the seed isn't as good as what I'd like it to be. And even with quality seed, that's a possibility. So I want to germinate the seeds separately from the soil pots, and then I'm going to introduce them into the soil pots afterwards. And I'll show you how I'm going to do that in a minute. But first, to prepare the seed, if I want 16 tomato plants, I'm going to take 18 tomato seeds and I'm going to put them in a cup of water and set them off to the side overnight. And what this does is it removes the chemical inside of that seed that causes it not to germinate, that stunts its growth, so to speak, until just that right time. And so I'm going to soak them overnight. The same way I would sprout my alfalfa seeds, the same way I would sprout my mung beans, or any other seeds that I'm going to sprout for my rabbits or for me to eat, that's how I'm going to do these seeds. I'm going to put them in a container and rest them overnight, and then pour that juice off tomorrow morning. If you notice, when you soak your sprouts seeds overnight, tomorrow morning when you pour that juice off, it's brown. And that brown stuff is the phytic acid and the other phenols and stuff that inhibit the growth of that seed. So the quicker we get that out of the seed, the quicker we're going to get these seeds to germinate. And it's also going to make sure that that stuff is not in my soil, in my actual cup that I'm going to grow these in. So it's not inhibiting the growth ever. And that's my theory behind this. I've read several articles on it and watched several videos on YouTube, and they all seem to agree the same thing. Soaking your seed before you put it in ground in the soil helps. Now, the next thing I'm going to do is I like to make sure that my seeds actually germinate, and that way I'm not waiting for a seed that didn't make it. An unfertilized egg, so to speak, is not going to give you a chicken. And the way I'm going to do that, we'll go upstairs in a minute and I'll show you exactly how I'm going to do that. Now, what I've done is I prepared some wheat berries overnight. I haven't purchased my other seeds yet. I'm going to work with wheat. It's still just a little bit early for me to start my seed beds, but this gives you the idea ahead of time so that we can watch the progress of this hard wheat, and it will do the same thing that our other seeds are doing. We're going to use exactly the same system for all this stuff. Now, once again, some seeds we're not going to plant inside the house anyway. Would I soak those overnight? Certainly, if indeed you can figure out a way to put the sticky little seeds in the ground. But I find when I'm planting outdoors, it's easier just to use the dry seed out of the package and then water them really, really well so that the ground does the leaching process for me. Anyway, let's move from the office up to the kitchen and we'll get a look at what I'm going to do. Now, if you remember from last week, you remember I said to get some cheap paper towels. You take a cheap paper towel and tear it right down the middle. Now, one direction it tears real easy, and one direction it doesn't tear quite so easily. Then I placed it on a draining board here, and I moistened it with water. Now, it doesn't show up real well on here, but there's a paper towel there. This is my wheat that has been soaked all night and rinsed. Typically, this stuff will germinate tomorrow. It germinates very, very quickly. I like that. And I'm going to take these little pieces of wheat berry and I'm going to space them out on here. Oh, at 1-inch intervals or 1.5 inches or something like that so that I can see them. And I don't want them too close together so that I can separate them later. You say, well, this looks like an awful lot of trouble to go through. Well, it kind of is, but you know, I'm not a huge gardener. I'm a small gardener, and I like to get a lot of bang for my time. And if I'm going to go through all the trouble of putting this stuff in the ground, I just assume it was viable before it got in the ground. Okay, as soon as you get those seeds on there, you take your paper towel and just fold it right up over the seeds like that. In this case, it's pretty wide, so I'm going to double fold it. Now, I don't know if you can tell, but you can still see the seeds through the paper towel. In fact, these seeds will grow right through that paper towel. Now, I have back here, I have some egg carton. And I'm going to, before I put these in my germinator, I'm just going to take that paper towel and put it right on that egg carton, just like that. Now, that's going to allow for this to stay drained, and yet the paper towel will keep it moist, and tomorrow, I can moisten this just as though I was sprouting these seeds to eat or otherwise, but we'll be able to watch their progress right through the paper towel here. And when they're germinated well, and of course they're being kept in the dark now, so there's no green. When they're germinated well, I can take a pair of scissors or I can just tear this right down the middle and put one of these seeds in each one of the cups. And we're all ready to go. So we don't have to worry about any of our seed cups sitting around with a seed that is not going to grow, just taking up space. So there we have about 10 or so wheat plants ready to go in our germinator. Okay, let me get the germinator set up and we'll take a look. And there's a shot down inside the germinator. Off here on this side, we have a gallon jug. It's a glass jar full of water with the heater in it. And that heater will bring that water up to about 80 degrees because it's set for yogurt. And I will vary the temperature. There's a thermostat on the top. And the seeds are down there in the bottom. Now, this is a big cooler. So there isn't any reason why I couldn't stack a whole bunch of those egg crates on top of each other down there with seeds on them. And of course there's plenty of room left on top of that egg crate for more seeds. So I could have almost an entire garden's worth of seeds inside of this cooler germinating all at the same time without any problem at all. The egg cartons are stiff enough that even when they get wet, they're not going to fall apart on you. And easy to carry right to the greenhouse when you get ready to go. Now, obviously, you can do all this inside your greenhouse if you can make your greenhouse dark so that these are in the dark. That would be fine. The advantage is, I'm not going to put any dead seeds in a pot. Every one I plant is going to be a good one. And if there are any choices between a puny one and a good strong looking one, I'll have it right here before we go to our seed pots. Okay, that takes care of our seed propagation video. And tomorrow I will come back and we'll get another look at these and we'll get another look at them. Today is Saturday. We'll get another look at them on Monday. And Monday we'll add some more to this video before we put it up at AroundTheCabin.com on Monday night for my show. Thanks for watching. Kevin Bacon. Bye for now.